Welcome back to A Journey of a Basketball Player, Mexico, Volume 2. As I take you inside my basketball journey in Mexico, as you can see from the previous episode, we're traveling stateside in Mexico right after we left the airport. So all of us pretty much got in like two to a taxi. And we were heading, you know, to the cities in Mexico and the places that we were staying at, I guess. We did quite a bit of traveling. We got to see some of the locals and how the people in Mexico interact. And it was quite interesting. We actually went to stop. I don't think we have it on here, but we went to stop and we met some kids that were barefooted, and see, you know, how privileged we are in the United States, you know, to have just the simple things, the basics, like tennis shoes. Like some of these kids, they would work just to bring something to eat, you know. They would eat, like we bought some food and they was ate right after us, you know, just to survive. So, you know, it showed us, gave us some humility and kind of humbled us. But, you know, as you see, I'm just showing some of the stuff, you know, some of the things that we're driving by. Their highways are kind of different. It's the same but different. And just, you know, certain things you see. Once you go over there, you see why, you know, certain people interact when they get, you know, stateside, because what they're used to, and then when they come, you know, across to United States, you know, it's a totally different feel. But you kind of understand why they do what they do, you know. And I learned a lot about the people, because they're great people. You know, everybody was welcoming. But like I said, we're just traveling. That's me right there, just traveling around, just showing you, you know, what's going on. Our taxi driver, he was kind of crazy, you know. He's a good guy, but he was a funny guy too. Said some crazy things I can't say, you know. Maybe kids be watching this, but he said a lot of explicit stuff. But you know, it was a fun time. As I say. So I hear, you know, to nightfall. We actually switched spots. We got to where we was going to, and we switched taxis. And I believe we're in, I think, the city of Morelia, if I take it. And once we got there, the taxi drivers, man, they drive pretty fast, man. They drive kind of fast and furious. I think they had like a 91 through 94 Nissan Sentra, and they like to drive pretty fast. So he was moving. His taxi, man, going through the city. And I think that's why I kind of reported it, because, you know, he was shifting and, you know, we were just ducking and dodging, you know, through cars trying to get to the hotel. The funny part is, once we reached the hotel, as you see right here, there is a group of people out in front, and as you see more in the video, we're getting out, you know, we're checking out the scenes. And at first we was thinking maybe, you know, these people they knew about the camera crew and stuff like that, so that's why they're waiting for us or something like that, like we're rock stars. But that wasn't really the case, because we see the hotel personnel in front. The biggest team in Mexico, Chivas México, they happened to stay at the hotel. And that is why all the people were in front of the hotel. So you had the people and personnel. And the funny thing about it is, like, they were supposed to stay at this hotel because this is the bigger hotel. It's more luxurious. But they actually stayed at the one that we were supposed to go to because the taxi drivers dropped us off at the wrong one. So there's one down the street. And my boy Tim happened to walk down the street and come get us. And was like, yeah. So the people, they're all looking at this hotel. And they got it caged off. But they weren't really at this hotel. I believe they were at the one that we were at. Because we got to meet the trainers and the coaches and the players as we were going through the hotel. So it was interesting, like very, very interesting. But then again, it could have been there. I mean, like I said, the first team could have been there. We could have met the second team, all that matters. But we know that we met the guys over there too, like the team doctors, because they helped some of the guys in the morning time with certain stuff. Across the street, they had like bars and like a grill and stuff like that. So it was the city that we were in. It was more modern, and they had more stuff to do. So it was nice. It was way nicer than some of the other stops that we went along the way. But as far as everything else, I mean, like I said, man, the experience, it was a Holiday Inn. And there's two. There's this one. There's another one. And the other one, we went to Applebee's for dinner afterwards. And we're just around here, and you can see the people there just waiting to get a glimpse of the players. And like I said, we thought they were like waiting for us. We're like, wow, we're superstars. But they wasn't waiting for us. They were waiting for the players just to get a glimpse of what's going on. But, you know, me walking around, and then Tim, he comes from the other end and is like, hey guys, I don't know why the heck they dropped you over here, but you're supposed to be down the street. So we had to grab our bags and walk all the way down the street. And it was close, but you know, we have our bags on us, so it was close but far at the same time. But you know, we got to the end result of where we were supposed to get, me and Gerald. And I guess we enjoyed our night. So like I said, stay tuned to the journey. There's more. And I'm gonna keep you posted on the adventure. But